We will be free! For when the rising tide is turned in every London quarter, Parliament comes crashing down with Robert's Rules of Order!
If we do this, by the time we get a month done, we're going to be flash.
That's kind of the idea. I had to, for the nap quiz, is when I the special orders really threw me for a loop. All right, we are continuing. It is allegedly the 17th. We are catching up to the future. It's like the Langoliers, if you ever watched that Stephen King movie where they slowly catch up to the future.
We're eliminating the backlog.
We're eliminating the backlog, which
drives people crazy, but well, here we are.
Well, here we are, and we almost did that in Colorado, but now we're getting foiled. Them and the Wascally Rabbit. Okay. The seventh.
Be very, very quiet.
Oh boy, yes. I am already almost through a beer. And I'm a lightweight when it comes to that. So
I'm taking it slower, but I'll tell you this right now. There's two things in the world that work better when you're plastered. Parliamentary procedure and Shakespeare.
Yes.
Trust me on the Shakespeare. I got an A in it in college on a junior level class while I was plastered out of my mind as a freshman.
I think I'm going to move up to the like margaritas eventually or Goldschlager. Woof. All right. So the 17th. Here's the question, Mr. Seebeck. Are you ready?
No, but here we go anyway.
Ooh, this is an interesting one. I'm not sure I would know this.
Uh-oh.
Under certain circumstances, which of the following motions may become debatable? Motion to create a blank. Motion to reopen the polls. Motion relating to nominations made while election is pending. Or point of order. And I forgot to give you the letter, so I'm going to go through it again.
Yeah.
Under certain circumstances, which of the following motions may become debatable? A motion to create a blank. B, a motion to reopen the polls. C, a motion relating to nominations made while an election is pending, or D, a point of order.
Okay, let's call those in reverse. A point of order is not a motion in the first place, so we can eliminate that one. Let's see, what was C again about?
Motion relating to nominations made while an election is pending.
While the election is pending means the vote is being taken on the election.
And then somebody nominates somebody else.
At which point the time for nominations has passed. So I don't think that's the case unless the people you're voting for are determined to be not eligible after voting has started. But that would just throw the vote out.
Yeah, that whole thing confuses me.
Yes, I don't think it's that one. What's B?
A motion to reopen the polls.
That one, I think, could be debatable under what I just described a second ago. So let's not rule that one out. A
motion to create a blank.
Create a blank.
We don't use that much in Colorado.
We don't drawing a blank on that one.
Yeah, I use it in committees and national, but I have to tell you, I've never seen it used in Colorado or at the national convention.
Well, what would the blank be?
Okay, a motion to create a blank would be, let's say we're going to have a meeting on the 10th.
Uh-huh.
And we don't know whether we want to have it in Colorado Springs or in Westminster or in Castle Rock. So we'll say, we move to meet on the 10th at blank.
Okay.
And that creates a blank. So we first vote on the meeting date, uh-huh, and then we vote to fill in the blank.
Oh, okay. That makes sense.
I mean, that's probably a very clumsy example.
Well,
but
no, it helps.
Yeah.
It helps. The question is whether that emotion becomes debatable?
Yeah. That emotion to create a blank.
I don't know why that couldn't be debatable, because, you know, if the emotion is, like, is to create something at a specific time or place, and that may not work for people, there may be a better idea, that would be part of a debate on the motion.
It seems to me, and correct me if I'm wrong, that it seems to me that this question is assuming that all of these motions are typically undebatable.
Hmm.
Because it says they may become. Is that how you're understanding
it,
too?
Yeah, that's a fair statement, yeah.
And I can't say whether they were. I'm not so good sometimes on which things are debatable.
I'm going to go with B, and I'm not sure why.
Okay.
I'm calling it, call it instinct, I guess.
I would not have known the answer to this. And you're gonna yell. The answer is D, a point of order.
What?
I know. I don't know why that's right yet either.
A point of order is not a motion by definition.
I I agree with you, but let's look let's look and see if the priests will instruct us in this theology. Okay. Yeah, to me, that's not here. It's not a motion, but okay. So reference, page 248. There's two references, and there one's on 248 and one's on 249. So page 248, lines 24 through 33, okay. Continuing on page 249, then to lines 21 through 25. God, I hate the way they do that. So 248 is the first reference at the end, towards the end, 24 through 33.
Yeah, they're both on the same open page. So.
And that is in the section entitled Point of Order, which is, look, it's calling it an incidental motion, though. It's saying a point of order is an incident. And I wouldn't call it that. But
I certainly wouldn't call it that.
But they are. So we learned something.
Because if a point of order is considered an incidental motion, then that also would apply to the number of times you can speak on a subject during a day, because incidental motions are attached to main motions, and that covers the limitations on debate.
No, because incidental motions, you get two times on each. So if you, like, for instance, in a secondary motion, you do a motion to amend.
Right.
Even if you've spoken twice on the main question, you could speak twice on the amendment. So I don't think so. I just don't, I guess because the word move is not in there, but...
Right. Well, here's what it says.
This makes it more clear. Okay. We say point of order, but it makes it clear here that what you're really saying is I raise a question of order. So if you think about it, I move to raise a question of order. That then makes sense as a motion.
Which then raises the question that doesn't need a second.
No, probably be one of the few that don't.
Yeah, because I'm just kind of skimming real fast.
That's interesting, but it doesn't say that.
No, it does not require a second on...
what page?
249, line 17.
Okay, see, we are learning a lot.
And, yeah. Okay, so what is what they say on the first, but 248, 24?
On 248 lines, so you can read it, because your question,
yeah,
so you can...
24 through 32, it says... In cases where the chair, being in doubt, refers the point of order to the judgment of the assembly, where the point thereby becomes debatable, it, like a debatable appeal, also yields to the necessary motions, etc., and so on, yields to the motions to commit and postpone definitely, not indefinitely, provided that they are in order at the time of the court and the order presses the motions, and yields to incidental motions arising out of itself.
That makes sense.
That's a mouthful.
But now I understand. So a point of order typically would not be debatable because it's to the chair and the chair alone, and the chair would make a ruling. But if the chair declines to make a ruling and says, I'm not sure, I will submit this to the judgment of the assembly, then it becomes debatable. That makes sense.
That doesn't happen very often, though, because usually the chair will consult the parliamentarian on some of this stuff, too, if he's not sure.
The last platform committee, I think I... Did I submit it to the assembly? We had so many points of order.
I don't remember.
I think there was one I did submit to the judgment of the assembly. Mm. And I got overruled on another one that I didn't. Mm. I still think I was right.
Now, the other page is 249, 21 to 25. It says, it's not debatable, but with the chair's consent, a member may be permitted to explain his point, and knowledgeable or interested members can be heard by way of explanation. If the chair submits the point of order to the assembly, the rules governing debatability are the same as for an appeal.
That makes sense.
I can buy into that.
But what really threw both of us is that it was a motion.
Mm-hmm.
And because you think point of order. But you also hear call the question, and people don't realize what you're really saying is you're moving to end debate.
Right.
We learn these little...
Subtleties.
Yeah, these little phrases, and we forget their shorthand.
Yeah.
Okay, well, I like it when we learn stuff, particularly when you and I were both on the same page and we're like, what?
Mm-hmm. So does that mean the next convention we need to say we raise a question of order?
That's shorthand. Yeah. I guess you could be obnoxious and be like, yes, Mr. Chair, I rise to move to raise a question of order, Mr. Chair.
And watch people's eyes roll and yeah. Eyes explode. which will make the hotel room happy, because that leaves them a mess to clean up.
Yeah. But in convention, it does get a little bit more formal, but yeah. I always think when it gets really crazy like that, all I can see is Mr. Starwork going, Yes, Mr. Star. Listen, he'll own that. He'll own that he's a mic hog, okay? He'll own that.
A what?
A mic hog.
What the heck's a mic hog?
Somebody hogs the mic.
Oh. No, that would be mic hog. Okay, got it, yeah. I thought you said something else.
No, I mean, I'm a mic hog, too. Yeah. So, listen.
I can be that way, but...
No, I'm like that way.
But I also know when I was sitting in St. Louis that I was on the end of a table line because there was a power outlet that I could use, and the microphone was right there.
And you'd jump.
And it would go around me to the microphone and back again and back again and back again to the point where I felt like I was in the middle of a whack-a-mole game.
This is me when there's a mic. I walk up.
I was getting ready to leg cuff him to his chair so he'd sit down and shut up.
Here's me. I walk up to the mic, say my point, and then walk right back to the end of the line.
I've seen her do that. Both at national conventions and at state conventions.
Yes, and I remember me and Aaron Starr in 2016, I'm yelling at him, "You're dilatory! No, you're dilatory!" It was wonderful. Wonderful. All right, well, that's it for the 17th. Cheers and adjourned.
Fever! Let's hear the opposition side. Like a stubborn donkey's bray, all opposed. You say nay, opposed! Opposed! The motion carries anyway.